Assalamualaikum. Hello everyone. Welcome back to my channel, The Maths Wood. Today I am here with midterm question paper, that is sample paper. We can call as model paper also. In my previous video, we had completed till question number 16. Now let us begin with the question number 17. Here in question number 17, they had given 3x plus solve 3x plus 4y is equals to 10 and 2x minus 2y is equals to 2. This question is from pair of linear equation. We can see here 2 equation. Let me write 3x plus 4y is equals to 10. I'll consider this as equation 1 and 2x minus 2y is equals to 2. This as equation 2. Here we can see in this two equation also nothing is same here. We cannot eliminate. So to eliminate, what we can do for these two, we need to make 4y. We can easily make 4y. So what I'll do, this second equation I'll multiply by 2. Okay, so how? First equation I'll keep as it is, 3x plus 4y is equals to 10. I kept as it is. Here this multiplied with 2 means we will get here 4c. 2 2's are 4x minus 2 2's are 4y is equals to 2 2's are 4. So what we will get now? We got plus 4y and minus 4y. So we can easily eliminate this. So 3x plus 4x, 7x is equals to 10 plus 4, 14. What we will get x value? X is equals to 14 by 7. 7 minus 7, 7 2 is a 14. What we got? X is equals to, we got 2 value. What we will do? Put 2 in equation 2. I'll do here. Put x is equals to 2. We got x is equals to 2, right? In equation, whichever we want, I'll take equation 1. So I'll write equation 1, 3x plus 4y is equals to 10. 3 x value, what we got? 2. In place of x, I will write 2 plus 4y as it is equals to 10. 3 2's are 6 plus 4y is equals to 10. 4y is equals to 10 minus 6. And 4y is equals to 10 minus 6 is 4. Y is equals to 4 by 4. 4 1's are 4 1's are. So y is equals to, we got as, y we got as 1. They have told to find the value of x and y. Solve means we have to find the value of x and y. We got x is equals to 2 and y is equals to 1. Let us see the next question now. If the product of two positive consecutive integers is 306, find integer. Okay. So here they have given, we will consider, let the two, what they have told, positive consecutive integers be x and x plus 1. Okay, two they have told, two positive integers, so x and x plus 1. According to the question, what they have told, product of these two integers is 306. Product between, so x into x plus 1, product of these two integers is 306. What? Find the integer. Let us solve this. X into x, x square plus x ones are x. This 306 I'll bring here. It becomes minus 306 is equals to 0. Now we have to do factorize. We know how to do factorize. First and last number we will multiply, that is 306 x square. Now three factors of 306 we will find. Okay. It will go in 3 table. Oh, okay. 3 ones are 3. 0 as it is. 3 twos are 6. Now it will go in 2 table, 2 5's are 10, 2 1's are 2. Again it will go in 3 table, 3 1's are 3, what remains? 2 remains, 3 7's are 21 and 17 is a prime number. Okay, let us multiply here, 3 2's are 6, 6 3's are 18, yes we got 18, 18 and 17. We need middle number. When we add and subtract, how we will find the factors? See, 306 x square, we should find two such number. When we add or subtract, we should get middle number. Now we got 18 and 17 by prime factorization. So 18x 17x plus 18 minus 17. Why? Because we need plus sign in between. So let us write x square plus 18x minus 17x minus 306 equal to 0. Now let us make this as two group. 1, 2. So in first group, what is common? X is common. We got x plus 18. Why? Already x is common. Here I will take minus sign common and 17 I will take common. x as it is, minus I have taken common, so it will become plus 17, 18 is 306 because we have multiplied c. 17, 18 is 306. So now, which bracket is common? X plus 18 is common. So I'll write once remaining x minus 17. In the question, they have told positive integers, right? So x is equals to this will become minus 18, and this is nothing but x is equals to 17. Therefore, x is equals to 17, and one more is x plus 1 is equals to 17 plus 1. So 18. Therefore, the two consecutive integers are 17 and 18. So this is the question number 18 we completed. Let us see question number 19 now. Find the HCF and LCM of 12, 15 and 21. Okay. Question number 19. HCF and LCM of 12, 15, 21. Okay. We will find the factors first. 2, 6 are 12. 2, 3 are 6. 3, 1 are 3. Okay. 15 factors. 3, 5 are 15. 5, 1 are 5. Correct. Now 21 factors. 3 sevens are 7 ones are. This all we should do with the prime numbers only. Prime numbers in the sense, the number which does not come in any table. Okay. So these are the prime numbers I have taken. So factors of 12, let us see. 2 square into 3. Okay. Factors of 15, 3 into 5. And the factors of 21, 3 into 7. What is the HCF in this? Let us find the HCF. What is common? We can see 3 is common here, here and here. So the HCF is 3. What about LCM? I'll write LCM. LCM in this, first 3 is common. So I'll take 3 one time. Then remaining all we have to take 2 square, 5 and 7. All remaining we have to take. So 3, 2 square is 4. 4 3 is 12. 12 5 is 60. 60 into 7. 6 7 is 42. So LCM is 420. Okay. So here the question number 20 is, find the value of y if the distance between point, what is the given points, 2 minus 3 and which point, q, 10 comma y, and the distance is 10 unit they have told. Okay, find the value of y. We all know the distance formula. D is equals to root of x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square. This is the distance formula. Now distance they have given 10 units. So I'll write 10 as it is. Root of first point x1 y1, second point x2 y2. Okay. So x2 minus x1. X2 10 formula minus as it is. X1 value is 2 whole square as it is. Plus y2 value y minus sign as it is. Y1 is minus 3 whole square. So 10 is equals to root of 10 minus 2, 8 square plus y minus minus plus whole square. Now we can see here there is no square and here there is a root. So we should need to remove the root. So what we will do, squaring both sides. By squaring both sides, the root will go. Squaring both sides, we will square both sides. 10 square is equals to root of 8 square, I'll write 64 plus y plus 3 whole square. Complete square I have done, squaring both sides. Now 10 square it will become 100 is equals to square and root got cancelled. So 64 plus y plus 3 whole square. 100 minus 64. I bought 64 this side, so it becomes minus, is equals to y plus 3 whole square. So y plus 3 whole square is equals to 100 minus 64 is nothing but 36. Now square, if I'll take this side, it becomes root. Y plus 3 is equals to square, I'll take this side, plus and minus root 36. Y plus 3 is equals to plus minus root 36 is nothing but 6. Now we have here plus and minus, so we will do one time plus and one time minus. Y plus 3 is equals to 6. And y plus 3 is equals to minus 6. Y is equals to 6 minus 3. So y is equals to 6 minus 3 is 3. Y value we got minus 1 is 3. Let us see one more value what we get. Y is equals to minus 6 minus 3. And y is equals to both minus means plus. minus 9. So this is about the question number 20. Let us see the next question. Here I have a question number 21, but these 21, 22, 23 and 24 I'll do in my next video. So do like and share and subscribe my channel. Thank you.